हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन, वी आर गोइंग टू सी द पॉपुलर एक्लिप्स इन रिजर्वायर इंजीनियरिंग। सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द ऑल द बेसिक प्रोसीजर्स फॉलोड इन द एक्लिप्स। सी व्हाट आर द इनपुट डाटास, हाउ यू आर मेकिंग द ऑल द वेल डाटास इन द एक्लिप्स प्रोग्राम and how you are doing the step wise. Let's go to the presentation. So reservoir simulation. So you are going to see the today the introduction to your Eclipse software, which is a very popular one in the reservoir simulation. And what are the steps followed, what are the input datas, what are the properties which are you are utilizing in the simulation. So this Eclipse 100, or what is the meaning? So why we use this simulator or software in your petroleum engineering? So it is a fully, you know, the explicit functions and implicit functions, and the three phases, three dimensional, and of the to create the black oil simulator or with the gas condensates. So it's used to simulate all the primary, secondary, and the tertiary phase, or single, double, or three phase system. The two phase options are solved in the two component system, but in addition to that, there will be a gas dissolving in the oil. That is a variable bubble point pressure or oil gas ratio is present. So that's why Eclipse 100 may be used to model oil vaporizing in the gas. So you know that we already learned in my previous presentation what is center point geometry, CPG, how to do it, and what are the concepts, conventional block center geometry and center point geometry. So these options are available in the Eclipse. So a radial and Cartesian block center options are also available in 1, 2, 3 or three dimensions. So this is the general information of this Eclipse 100. See, what we are going to do is the general information we have done. Then we have to see the section header, keywords, what you are putting inputs, then keywords in the sections, data file structure. So how you run the simulation and the result of the simulation, how you are getting, and the exercise. So these are the steps which are we are going to see today. So this is the section header keywords. So what are the list of section header keywords in the proper order? So run specification, grid datas, editing, props, regions, solution, summary, and schedule. So this, all these section must be specified in the above shown order only, and these sections are should not be changed in the different files. It should be included in the data. That is include as a keyword, and a data record has to be ended with a slash. So this is a section header keywords in, to be followed in this manner, in this order. Next one, so the general information again. So in this Eclipse data, so all the input files are separated, or you can say that split into sections. So each of these you are introduced by the section header keywords. All the section header keywords is there, and all the section list of section header keyword is given in the below, together with the description of the each contents of the each section and examples of the keywords utilized in the file code. So you have to remember that all the keywords in the input files has to be in the proper order. So as I told you, the keywords in the input file is includes the section header keywords of each is having the 8 characters in the length and must be start in column 1. So all the characters columns up to column 8 are which are significance, and the column 9 will be treated as a commented section. So these are the general information of the input files which are going to utilize in the Eclipse. So you can go through it again, then we'll go to next. So section header keywords. So you can see the section header keywords, run specifications, then this title, problem dimension, what are the switches, what are the phases present, and the components, and the grid section. So grid is your basic the geometry of the simulation grid, and various rock properties should be there, like porosity, absolute permeability, and then net to gross ratios in the each grid cell. So this is the section header keywords, run spec grid. Then section header keywords. So again, edit props. So any modifications which are to be calculated, like so you are getting the pore volume, grid block, center depths, and transmissibilities. So you can edit. And the tables of properties of reservoir rocks and fluids as a function of fluid pressures, saturations and compositions like density, viscosity, relative permeability, capillary pressure, etc. And also it contains the EOS, equation of state, or description in compositional runs. So next one, sectioner header keywords. Section header keywords, you can see here the all the regions. So what are the regions are there, then what are the solution. So in the region section again, it splits computational grid into regions for calculation. What are the calculations? So you know that in the reservoir engineering, so all the pressure PVT properties. So we already learned a lot of things on PVT, like your pressure temperature relations, etc. So fluid densities and viscosities. So it is written as it is PVT NUM. Then saturation properties. So relative permeabilities and capillary pressures are noted as SAT NUM, SATNUM. Then initial conditions, equilibrium pressures and saturation, EQL, that is equilibrium, NUM, equilibrium number, and fluids in place and interregional flow, FIP, NUM. So if this section is deleted, then all the grid blocks are located or can be put in the region 1. Then next is solution. So specification of initial conditions in reservoir. So what are they? So they are calculated using the specific fluid contact depths to give potential equilibrium. So it should be read from the restart file set up by earlier runs, and also the specified by the every user for every grid block. So this section may be sufficient and the data to define the initial states, that is pressure, saturations, composition, and the every grid block in the reservoir. Next one, the section headers keywords again, summary and schedule. So summary, so specification of data should be written in the summary file in each time. If it is necessary, you can make the graphical output also. For example, water cut as a function of time to be generated once the run has to be finished. Then schedule. So it is specifically the operations like production and injection controls and other constraints, and the times at which the outputs reports are required. And the vertical flow performance curves and simulated tuning parameters also specified in the schedule section. So keywords in the section. So you can see that run specification, run spec section, title, dimensions, number of blocks in XY directions, then active phases which are presence, oil, water, gas, water, etc. Then field metric and lab unit conversions. Then well dimensions, well and group dimensions, UNIFIN indicates the input files are unified. Then UNIFOUT indicates that output files are unified. Then start. Start the date of the simulation and checking the file and with no simulation, no simulation. So this is the keywords in run specification section. So you can see the right side. So you entered the file, all the data, soil, water, gas, field, then well dimension, start. So this is the run specification section. Then next is your grid section. So here in the grid section, tops, that is depths of top faces of grid blocks. And this data is taken from the all the structural maps and geological model from Petrel. Then XYZ directions, that is DX, DY, DS. That is the direction of grid block sizes of the current box. It is taken from ISOPAC map or geological model from Petrel. Then PERMX, PERMY, PERMZ. So this is XY is a direction permeabilities of the current box. And this data is taken from ISOPAC map, geological model from Petrel. Then porosity. So grid block porosities of the current box. So poro. You can see in the left side the grid section. Data is taken from ISOMAG map and geological model from Petrel. So the array value is shown in the right side. You can see here the values. So this is the description of your grid section. So next one, this is prop section, that is properties section. So here you can see the water relative permeability, water relative permeability and capillary pressures and three phase system. Then you can see the PVTO, PVTG, compressibility factor, then density, then rock compressibility. So this is the property section. You can see here. So you see the PVT properties of water, oil relative permeability. You can see the for gas also. So this is your prop section. Oil relative permeability in three phase system and gas relative permeability, viscosity RS, RV, then compressibility, density and rock compressibility. So these are the PVT properties of water. You can see here in the right side. So keywords in this region section, that is fluids in place regions. So I already explained this one, SATNAM, FIPNAM, SATNAM, equilibrium regions and PVT data regions. Then this is your solution section. So equilibrium, restart, then RPT, SOL. So that is your fluid contact depths and other equilibrium parameters, data taken from well testing, name of the restart file, then report switches for solution data. So this is the data for initializing fluids to potential equilibrium. So please go through it and see the small file which is showing after the input. So these are the oil order contact, water oil contact, the numerical discretization of this aquifers model. So WOC, numerical discretization. Then modeling the aquifers. So we are modeling the aquifer model. So you know very well. So you will do the effective which model, Carter Tracy, then numerical aquifers, closed system and breeding. So these are the numerical and analytical aquifers models. So for the aquifers, the keywords is numerical. So run specs again, the grid, the starter. So in order to, you see, first one is run specification. So you have to number the numerical aquifer blocks and the maximum number of lines, the connection that aqu, CYN, then aqu DIMS. Dimensions, then aqu con to connect a numerical aquifer to one or more reservoir cells. So this will be set up by an arbitrary box defined by lower and upper IJK indices. That is your aquifers numerical. You can see here the numerical. So you are using the one numerical aquifers up to three grid blocks connections. Aqu, DIMS. So please see the screen. You can see the aquenum. So IJK cross sections is shown, length, porosity, permeability, depth, PVT table and SAT table. So you can see very clearly here aquenum, then aqu con also shown. So here, so aquifer one you can see is connected to the cells of the first three layers of the fifth column of the XZ cross section. Explanation of the run spec. So this is the effect of which run spec. So you should use the maximum number of analytic aquifers and maximum number of grid blocks by a single analytic aquifer should be used in the run spec section of the keyword aqu dams. Then the solution of the property, aquifer properties, density, PA, depth, PA, etc. should be defined by the keyword aqu FETP. So it is connection to one or more faces of the reservoir and we should be made through the keyword aqua con, your effect of which. So this is the effect of which modeling. So theory you would have studied already, but this is the, we are doing this one with the help of the, as per the Eclipse procedure. Then aquifers, again Carter Tracy. So similarly, run spec, probes, solution. So again, you have to use the maximum number of analytic aquifers and maximum grid block. You have to connect for the single aquifer using the run spec keywords, then prop section. Then again, solution, aquifer properties, depth or C, density using the keywords, aquacity, etc. The keyword is aquen con. So Carter Tracy. So Carter Tracy, you can see here the after the input. So you are getting like this for Carter Tracy aquifers. See the everything, porosity, resistivity, angle, PVT table, aquen con is shown in the bottom. Aquen con numericals. Then next one, summary section. So in the summary section, so you'll see the field quantities, group quantities, region quantities and well quantities, then connection quantities, then block quantities. So this is our summary section in the Eclipse. You can see the right side, the output of the summary field data. Next one. So the summary section again, FOPT field or well oil production tool, oil well production tool, then that is production rate, gas oil ratio, GOR, field or well water cut, well water injection rate, WWIR, WIT, field oil, water injection total, field oil in place, field oil efficiency, then field pressure, field fraction, total oil produced by rock compaction. So you can see all the things are denoted. Then FORFG, total oil produced by water or gas influx. Then field fraction of total oil produced by the oil expansion or gas expansion. So these are the keywords. So keywords in section again. So well bottom hole pressure or tubing head pressure, WP, WB, P5. Then well productivity index based on the value of WP5 or WPV9. Then well oil production rate or oil production total history. Then well water cut or GOR history, WGORH. Then well control, well mode control, WMCTL, time of CPU usage, TCPU. So this is your summary section. So the you can see everything the left side. Then schedule section. So RP report switches, schedule, then time step, tuning, so well specifications, then compact data, then control data for injection, then control data of registry, then advanced simulator for new report. That is your TSTP date. So you can see the completion specification data and well specification data. So again, you can see here. Then this is your reservoir simulation modeling. So this is the our overview. You can see here the geological model design problem definition, then geological model fill in, dynamic model construction, then dynamic model testing, then field development model, then model evolution during the time. That is from there you have history matching, forecasting, history match, forecasting, then data review occasion, then data review occasion. So you can see the output of seismic, exploration wells, appraisal wells, production wells, and new wells, new techniques. So this is your block diagram of your reservoir simulation modeling. So appraisal wells, you can see the fault, interferences, heterogeneities, locks, reservoir pressure, cartography, then fluid sampling for PVT analysis, etc. So this is your reservoir simulation modeling. Then main controls, that is your history matching and observed average rates are known. So the VFT tables are introduced at the end of history matching to ensure the continuity between the runs and prediction times. That is main control. So forecasting, main control. So what you are doing? So imposed flow rates, then imposed pressure. So how much your flow rate you are imposing for the oil, water, gas, liquid and reservoir voidage. Then imposed pressure, tubing head flowing pressure and bottom hole flowing pressure. secondary control for casting of the well control, that is your economic limits, then rates upper limit, surface, then we are going to see the GOR, gas oil ratio, then maximum ratio, WCut and WGR, then pressure is bottom wall pressure, BHP and THP limits. So it's lowest for wire for producer and upper for an injector, then maximum drawdown pressure. And TFP, VFP tables are used to relate the bottom wall pressure to wellhead pressures, and these VFP tables provide the data. So you can see the VFP tables used to provide the outflow relationship between bottom wall conditions near well and wellhead pressure. And also they characterize the capability of the well to lift the fluids to the surface. So this is very important. Next one. So well constraints. See, what are the well constraints? Technical, economical, for the simulator, pressure target, maximum or imposed, WHP, BHP, then minimum for producer and maximum for the injector, and rate target, Q0, QG and QL, Q for the oil, gas and liquid. Then QT, that is bottom issue matching, and the secondary constraints, WCT, GOR and P limits. These are the well constraints you are facing. Then the group of well constraints is your rates on for main phase, then rates for the secondary phase, this is your gas lift rate and capacity of flaring, water treatment, etc. Then the dependency, that is Q produced equal to F multiplied by Q injection, then pressure maintenance, etc. And the monitoring, so opening of waiting wells and shutting of the most of the water flooded well. So this is your group of well constraints explained in the your Eclipse. So again the keywords for the well definition, control and schedule section. So RPTRST, well specification and completion, well specs, complete data, then production constraints, etc. So well specification for data for wells. So you can see here well specs. P1 group produced to I, J, BHP and phase is our oil. The P1 belongs to the group of production, PROD production. Well, it is at I20. You can see the I20 and J equal to 7. And BH reference depth is given 2500 to depth of most topmost connection. Then oil is preferred phases. Other terms are default. Then second is your well completion, compact, comp data. Well completion specification data. So you can see here, well P1 is completed in layers 3 to 8 of column I20 and J7. And the wellbore diameter is 0.5 meters and the skin is +2. And also this Eclipse, you can compute the connection factors using the Peisman formula for vertical well using the KH values of the completed cells. Similarly, you can see the completion data for the deviated well crossing columns in the layers of 3 to 5. And the CF have been calculated schedule in and the input items 8, the wellbore diameter must be given. Then K skin direction or the penetration also given. It is your well completion compact data. So you can see here everything, all the values. Then production well control, control data for production. So how we are doing? So you can see the WCON production 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Name, status, control, Q, oil and gas, oil, water, and Q, gas, liquid, solid, BHP, THP, and VHP. So this is your W well control production. The so well P1 is a target oil rate of 500 and subject to maximum rate of 300. Maximum gas rate is 1000. So Q all specified as the gas rate, flow rate, the minimum BHP of 50 and minimum THP of 15. So we are using the VFP table which applies to this well. Then economic limit data for production wells. So again, this one, economic constraints. So this is your injection constraints. So what are the how the injectors are controlled? And the injectors are controlled by target rate and fixed pressure. So that is surface or reservoir pressure rate of the injected fluid and target BHP subject to maximum rate. So this is your injection constraints. So now this is injection well control, W control ING in there. So same you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, name, phase, status open, THP, QS, QRES, etc. So the maximum rate of 1000 SM³ by per day. Bottom wall pressure is of 300 barometric. So you can see the data. So other well controls, so the well procedures, opens and closes both wells and completions. P1 opens, P1 does not alter after the completion, and P2 stop closes, but P2 allows the cross flow, and P3 open, so opens for all completions, and P4 shut in, closes all completions in P4 in layer 2, then shut in the SHUT action and closes completions 4, 5, 6 of P5. So this is the other well controls in your. So now other well controls, WE for, so well activity or efficiency factor. Well efficiency, well activity or well efficiency factor in the downtime. So efficiency is 0.95. So the well P1 is having the 95% of the time on production, and the model is shut down on the day of one of each one. Next one. So this is your concluding remarks. RPTS schedule. Then well specs. So the basic Eclipse well model is acceptable for vertical and deviated wells and acceptable for horizontal wells if the friction losses of the drain is negligible. Then it always try to calibrate simulated well productivity against measured or calculated values. So RPT schedule and well specs. So this is the file connected in the PRT file. Then tuning, time step management and convergence. So you have to tuning, set the simulator and the control given parameters. So you have to record time stepping controls, then truncation time, and convergence control. The record 3 is control of Newton and linear iterations. So this is the tuning. So next step sets a maximum length of the next time. So when you open the well, then data file structure. So in the for data following a keyword, so you have to use the star mark or asterisk to count the repeat the accounts. So also there will be no intervening blank space next to the star mark or asterisk on the either side. So twofold in cases which are equivalent. So this is the comment. So data file structure. So default values. So data, certain items of data files can be defaulted and built in a default file. So all the ending data should be with a slash, and the quantities remaining unspecified will be set for the default values. So this is the selected quantities position before the slash to be defaulted by entering n star. So for example, 4 star will cause the next 4 quantities in the keyword for the next default values. So this is a default well or the data file structure. So you can see here right side. So running simulation. So there are 2 ways to launch the simulation. So 2 ways to launch the simulation. So from the Eclipse Office launcher. There are 2 ways to launch the simulation. So now it is coming the all your, you can see the NVM plan, optional templates, datas, run, flow grid, Scal, PBT, schedule. So you can see everything. So this is the running of simulation will start. So while the model is running, the status report will be written in the file name PRT. So if your input file was not prepared properly, then the simulation will stop. So you can check for errors, the file name PRT files, and try to connect them. So when the run is finished, your folder contains the following. So file name DBG, file name E grid, then file name PRT, file name INIT, then file name SMSpec, then file name UNRST, then RSSpec, file name IN inspection. So this is your running the simulation. When your run is finished, so your folder containing the following files. So you can check it for errors on the file name PRT. So in your next step is your visualization of your obtained results. So this is your visualization. So script file with errors report and field well block performance in the Office application, then 3D view in FlowVis, file name, then file name INIT eGrid. So this is the visualization of results, the output files. So you can see here field well block performance in the Office application. So you are getting the visualization. The output files, FlowVis 3D view in the FlowVis application. So you can see here the visualization of the results. So this is the Eclipse exercises are available, and we have to simulate the behavior of the developed well development of the well, then optimize its location, data review and flow simulations. This is our objective. So what are the items you have to investigate? Production mechanisms, natural depletion, gas cap drive, water influx, water injection, and the well locations. What are the 8 location or 9 possible location for the production, or 2 possible locations for the injection. So this is your exercise, top of the reservoir, and you can see the X is a cross section of the geometry. So top 1960 meters TVD, then water oil contact at 2160 meters TVD, 2 vertical depth. You can see when possible well locations. So water oil contact 2160 meters TVD and top is 1956 meters, 2 vertical depth. So the location of the possible well location, and you can see the reservoir layering you are getting. See, you can see here layer 1. See, net thickness 6.6, net porosity, net permeability. This is your layer 2, what you are having. So net thickness, layer 3, layer 4, layer 5, and your well. So this is your net porosity, net permeability, millid RC, net thickness, and you can see the table very clearly, the layering, reservoir layering. So is your PVT functions, all oil PVT functions. So you know very well, I have posted also the PVT properties, pressure volume, temperature studies. So you will see here the formation volumes, the pressure, and here solution gas versus pressure, then oil density versus pressure, then you can see the oil viscosity versus pressure. So PVT functions. So same, you can get here oil gas PVT, that is for oil and this is for gas PVT. So there will be Z factor, compressibility factor, that is right side. Then we have the oil viscosity versus pressure, and gas density, and formation volume versus pressure. So water oil special core analysis and relative permeabilities, WO, water oil capillary pressure, as shown here. You can go through it. And gas oil special core analysis, GO, capillary, gas oil capillary pressure, and gas oil relative permeabilities. And the exercise again, what are the tasks? So you have to look at this Eclipse data file, then simulate the different scenario and visualize the results of 2D and 3D, and you have to compare each case. So what is oil recovery, what is water breakthrough, what is the water cut, gas oil ratio and pressure, and you have to check the Eclipse data files, so initial fluids in the place, etc., and expected drawdown at the well. So this is your task. So your exercise, you have to, for fluids, calculate the oil and gas compressibility in reservoir conditions and saturation functions, calculate the water gas or water oil mobility ratio of saturation pressure, then initial state. So you have to give the original fluids in place, that is OGW, oil and gas water, the reservoir and stock conditions. And also they are compatible with the PVT and SCAL data, pressure volume, temperature, and SCAL data. Then natural depletion, you have to calculate the contribution of rock compaction and fluid expansion to reservoir voidage and the well performance. So we have to see the well productivity by assuming the skin factor of 7. So thank you. So we have completed our presentation. So we have completed the basics of the eclipse modeling in reservoir. So you have learned the what are the files you are doing properly in the eclipse model. So in the next presentation we'll see more description on eclipse and also the other simulators like Petrel, etc. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.